Yo, that's salty. That's salty. What is up, everyone? I hope you're doing well. Welcome to a whole brand new beautiful day. It is about 11 o'clock here in Idaho Falls, Idaho. I spent the night at a truck stop, slept right here on my beautiful homemade bed. This is a Love truck stop. You've probably heard of this. It's everywhere all around the US and they allow overnight parking. So this is quite the convenient spot. So today my goal is to kind of just give you a glimpse at what living the van life is like, as well as solo traveling across America. So yes, I hope you enjoy. You can see we have little covers on all the windows, little fabric stuff that I attached on cardboard. Our first objective is to get rid of this. Holy, the gas is expensive today. Good morning, could I have 40 and number 5? Yes. Alright, thank you so much. This couldn't go one of two ways. We could flip the coin, I'll be your side. See this right here, this is from a whole other story. My car actually got towed because I parked illegally at one point on October the 5th, and it won't come off. My parents don't know about this. I really hope they don't see this video. Okay, so successfully got gas, yes. And now it's time to wash up at the gas station restroom. So I just successfully got ready. And now we have to do one more thing before we begin traveling. And that is checking the air pressure within each tire. Now that that's all finished, it's time to start traveling. So our goal today is to reach Great Salt Lake. It's the biggest humongous lake there in Utah. So from here in Idaho Falls, it's about a 2-hour drive. So gonna start that drive now. And you know why? You've been fucking with me since I was a small fry. And your ex-man, that's my little guy. I know some niggas that'll kick him to the coastline. I'm on West Side, nigga, we don't show signs. You got some fake friends, they just told lines. Text, I reply, baby, till my phone die. You know he lied if a nigga said he don't lie. I fucked up. Hello? I have secured the bag. So we are now about 10 minutes north of Salt Lake City, right next to Great Salt Lake. Got some lunch. And you know, as a very frugal traveler, someone who sleeps at truck stops and tries to spend as little money as possible, I found Subway to be the lesser of all evils, with just the right balance of, you know, healthiness and low price. So here we have the 6-inch. Wait, this is literally not even 6 inches. This is like, wait, it's like 5 inches. Yeah. And in the end, this entire thing costs only $6. So be able to have this entirely, oh, hello there. So to be able to have this entire experience of eating somewhat healthy food for only $6, it's very worth it with all things considered. You know, I try to only spend about $15 on food per day. So sometimes when I'm in a city and I realize, oh, there's this really nice place to eat, but it might be on the more pricey side, I end up just eating one meal that day. If that situation doesn't present itself, just eat 2 Subways a day. So healthy. Here. Take a look at that cross section right there. Take a look at that. Anyway, the place I'm going to today, it's this little artificial landform created by an artist in the 1900s, I think. It's called Spiral Jetty. But the issue is there really is no way to get there via Google Maps. So I found the directions on a random website. So I'll be referring to just my notes on my phone to get there. It's like, it's literally in the middle of nowhere. There's no cell service. There's no restrooms or amenities. It's just straight up just beach. Beach and artificial landform. Later. Hello, Just took a fat 30-minute nap right here in the van. Because I'm driving such long distances, driving fatigue is probably a really bad idea. I definitely have felt tired while driving at times. Yeah, just make sure to keep sleeping. I sure do. But anyway, now it is time to finally go to that random remote location that I have to find without using Google Maps. Let's go. So currently I have no idea where I'm going. So I apparently have to go 18 miles off of the highway west. And the way I'm gauging this is just by looking at my, is it the odometer? I don't know. So I added 18, and once the last two numbers go to 14, I should be one step closer to getting there. But you know, I have no idea where I'm going. I ran it up, that fucked it up, the black and orange have ended all, I left it up. I spurred from Sadie Beans, cause my credentials up. I told her I got my millions of these rags, baby. This only hard to goosebumps, rags, baby. Walking a little bit, and I noticed the ground is extremely white. And I remember, this is Great Salt Lake, that's salt! Let me try it. Is this salt? Let's try it. Oh, it's salt! Dang, I gotta take some home! Yo, this is a souvenir. So I've heard that Great Salt Lake at certain points in the year becomes pink, and I noticed the salt here has a pink tinge to it. So once I get there, hopefully the water is pink. The water is here. The water's right here. Oh my goodness, the water's pink. And the ground is complete. Just straight up salt. For miles, it's all pink. Yo, I should have brought a pickaxe. I've been standing in this water for the past hour, and I don't think video does this justice, just how beautiful this is. One more thing, all this time I've been here, and we haven't had a taste test yet. So, let us try. Yo, that's salty. That's salty. Alright, I'm gonna go take some pictures, and I will see you for the rest of the vlog. Hi. Now I just want to reiterate just how magical of an experience that was for me. You know, I truly don't believe that this video will do it justice. That was probably one of the most beautiful places I've been to in my entire life. So I hope by me experiencing this pink lake, y'all are able to just get a glimpse of just how beautiful nature can be. And on to the next location. Hi, so I told y'all that I was going to meet y'all at the next location, but take a look at this. That's so beautiful. There's not a person in sight. This lonely road goes on forever. I'm gonna take some pictures. I will see y'all later, as promised. Oh, there's a car coming. Hi, it's been a while. It's about 9 o'clock now, and I'm parked at the Love's truck stop that you saw earlier, where I got the subway. This is where I plan on sleeping for the night, and I do apologize for the really weird lighting. I'm using a flashlight right here because I don't want it to be too bright and, you know, get discovered in this parking lot. Although sleeping at truck stop parking lots is completely fine. You just have to call them beforehand just to make sure that they're okay with it. You know, but what I am scared of is, you know, getting mugged, getting kidnapped, getting shot, getting destroyed. Like, I'm not trying to have some like random person open up like this door here. But yeah, this is where I'm sleeping for the night. All the windows are covered, so hopefully people won't be able to see this light. Also, I parked strategically under like a sign, so people won't really be able to see the light that's shining through, you know, the cracks of all the windows and stuff. Hopefully no one knows, but you never know. So, car locked, got my weapons ready, but let me recount the past couple hours. It's right after that beautiful sunset drive in the middle of nowhere. I made my way over to
Planet Fitness. Planet Fitness is definitely a place that I look forward to going to every single day. But you know, the reason for going is not to work out, but instead it's to get a nice freaking shower. Let's go.
So this Planet Fitness, I would rate about, you know,
5 out of 10.
It's not the best place I've been. And you know, the reason why I go to Planet Fitness is so that I can shower. You know, showering is really important. And on the road, especially living in a van, it's very difficult to consistently find places to shower. So that's why I got a Planet Fitness membership. $24 a month, I think. Get free access to showers all throughout the United States at every Planet Fitness, which is the best deal. The other alternative to that is like showering at truck stops, but that costs like $10 to $14. So it's a much better choice to just go with Planet Fitness. So right after I got my shower, got cleaned up, brushed my teeth and everything, I went to
Mo Betas.
You know, today I've only spent $6 on food so far. And you know, that's a luxury that I think I can get because I'm paying $0 for like hotels because I'm sleeping at truck stops all the time. I kind of went all out on this dinner. It's paid $11.36. Anyway, let's get it with the mukbang. So, got my food right here. Oh yeah. There's a lot of trash to throw away on the road. And whenever you get access to one of these, you know you're good for like a good 3-4 days. Anyway, let's take a look. Oh my gosh. Okay. So we got some pork, some teriyaki chicken, and a whole bunch of rice. Excited to eat this. I don't know if it looks good on camera, but you know, in my perspective, that looks so good right now. Oh my gosh. Gotta make sure that light isn't seeping through too much. I hope no one knocks on my door. And take a look at this, guys. Teriyaki chicken, Hawaiian style. Oh, look at that, nicely charred. Oh my gosh. Oh, that's beautiful. Wish y'all were here, man. We can share this together. And I got way too much food for myself. Solo traveling do be kind of lonely, but hey, at least I got y'all. I do appreciate it. It's the only social interaction I get aside from cashiers. Yeah, that is so good. Get some of that brown rice. Now you feel a little less guilty about eating a whole bunch of carbs because it's brown rice, healthy rice. So this is kalua pork, another Hawaiian dish. Take a look at that. Golden on the outside. Try this. That's good too. How did I not discover this until today? On top of that, they threw some cabbage on the bottom, so you get your daily serving of vegetables too. Nothing more I could ask for. And I'm so glad that I had the chance to bring all of y'all along with me for this ride today. Do be sure to like and subscribe. Anyway, I'm gonna call it a night here. Love y'all so much. You've been fucking with me since I was a small fry. And your ex-man, that's my little guy. I know some niggas that'll kick him to the coastline. I'm on West Side, nigga, we on show signs. You got some fake.